अस्सलाम वालेकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू। वेलकम बैक क्लास 8 इन योर कंप्यूटर साइंस क्लास। टुडे वी स्टडी अबाउट दी लूप्स। इन दी प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैव टॉट यू अबाउट दी कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट, दैट इज इफ एज स्टेटमेंट। नाउ वी स्टडी अबाउट द लूप्स इन C++। लूप्स आर बेसिकली यूज व्हेन वी वांट टू राइट एनीथिंग मल्टीपल टाइम्स। Very simple example is if you want to print anything 5 times, right? You want to print any statement 5 times, like hello world. If you want to print this statement 5 times, so what we do, you can copy or paste, right? You just copy and paste that statement 5 times. Now suppose if I say that you have to copy this statement 100 times, then what you do, to copy and paste this statement, it takes a lots of time, right? So instead of doing this, what we use loops. A loop refers to a sequence of instruction that is repeated until a particular condition is satisfied. C++ supports 3 types of loops. That first is while loop, second is do while loop, and third is for loop. So first I'm going to show you how while loop works to print, and I'm going to write a program to print a table of a number using a while loop. So first we give hash include iostream dot h, and then hash include kunio dot h, then void main. Then we open parenthesis, then we give clrscr, then int a, cin a. It means whatever the value we give through the keyboard, we store in this variable a. Now we initialize the variable, int c is equals to 1. And the other variable int p is equals to 0. So the initial value of c and p, c is 1 and p is 0. Now here we give the loop while c is less than 11. Okay. Now we open parenthesis, and here we give p is equals to a multiplied by c. Then here c out p. Okay, now C++. Now we close the loop and then get ch, and then we close the program. Now how it works, see, this is the condition. When first the computer checks the condition, and then computer will run this block of code. Okay, now this is cout. It means whatever the value stored is stored in this value p will be printed on the output screen, and this is C++. It means that the value of c will increase by 1. Okay, now suppose if I give the value of a 2 through the keyboard, so that value will store here. Okay, and the initial value of c is what? The initial value of c is 1. Now what happens here, when here the value of c is equals to 1, now the computer will check the condition. So the 1 is less than 11, so the condition is true. So our computer will come here. Now here this operation will execute here. 2 multiplied by 1, what you get? You get 2. So this value 2 will get stored in this variable p. Now the next statement will execute it. Here, now see out P. It means whatever the value is stored here will be printed on the output screen. So the value stored here is true. So that value will get display on your output screen. Then the next statement is C++. It means that the value of C will increase by 1. The value of C is 1. Now when it will increase by 1, this value becomes 2. Now the value of C is 2. Now again the loops come here and check the condition that is 2 is less than 11. Now the value of C is 2, right? So 2 is less than 11, the condition is true. So again this statement will execute it here you get 2 to the 4. So now the value of P is 4. It means that the computer will print here 4. Okay, now again the value will increase by 1. Now the value will become 3 here. Now the computer checks the condition. 3 is less than 11. Yes, the condition is true. Then again, 3 twos are 6. Now this value is stored here in this variable. So the computer will print here 6. Now again, the value of C increased by 1. Now the value becomes 4. 2 fours are 8. Now again, the value 8 will be printed here. Again, the value of C increased by 1. So this will continue. This will continue until you get the value here 10. When you get the value of C is equals to 10, when you get 2 multiplied by 10, you will get 20. So that 20 will print it on your output screen. Now what happens? Now again the value of C will increase by 1. The initial value is 10. Now when you increase it by 1, it will become 11, right? Now the computer will check that 11 is less than 11, so the condition is false. When the condition is false, our loop stops and the program will execute it. So you will get the table of here, you will get the table of 2, right? Okay, let's execute this program in C++. So the first line, hash include iostream.h, hash include conio.h, then void main, then open parenthesis, then we give here clear screen. Then int a semicolon c in a. Then another variable int c is equals to 1 semicolon. Then int p is equals to 0 semicolon. Then next line, we give the loop while C is less than, 11. Then we open the parenthesis. Here we'll write. Here we make a small bracket here. Now here I have given the equation P is equals to A multiplied by C, then semicolon, then C out P, then slash N semicolon, then C plus plus semicolon. Now we close the loop and then get ch and then we close the program.
Now we'll run. So here I will give the value 2 through the keyboard. Then I'll press enter. Now you'll get I have, this is table of 2. Now again I'm going to show you. Now I'll give 3. Now this is the table of 3. So this is how for loops work.